It's almost a year since Japan was hit with the triple disaster, a massive earthquake, tsunami and nuclear meltdown.
Now, in an exclusive, TEN's foreign correspondent Hamish Macdonald has travelled into the nuclear exclusion zone to the village of Okuma to talk to those struggling to return to normality.
Well, Bill, Hamish has just arrived back in Tokyo and he joins us from there now. Hamish, tell us, what was it like for the residents returning home?
Look, this is a really important moment for them. They've been waiting a year. They haven't rebuilt their lives. They're still living in temporary accommodation. They were given just a few hours to go back because of the radiation threat, and we were given permission to go in with them.
It's the night before the big day. Katsuhiko and Yukari are going home tomorrow, the first time in almost a year. The girls want their games and books collected. Yukari hopes to find her mother's kimono collection. They've lost most of the life they had before. Their new existence is squeezed uncomfortably into this shipping container.
It's almost a year now since the incident, and TEPCO keeps sending me more paperwork, and it's too complicated for me. They shouldn't be making it so difficult for us to get compensation.
At 10 a.m. they register and receive protective suits. They'll have no more than 4 hours inside the nuclear exclusion zone. Katsuhiko is ignoring the safety advice, ditching the white suit, even though his Geiger counter reminds him every 30 seconds of the radiation exposure. A moment's prayer is given at the family shrine, but there's little time for tears. The calendar rests on March 2011, the month their life here stopped. We meet the neighbour. I'm frozen, she says. I just don't know where to start. Okuma is the closest village to the reactor, so the radiation threat here is very real.
Well, this is the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant. The big white building with the arched roof is reactor number one, and either side of that are reactors 2 and 3. Now, those are the ones that went into full meltdown last year. And even standing here, we're getting incredibly high readings on the Geiger counter, 9 and 10 microsieverts. That's dangerously high, so it's not really a good idea for us to stay here much longer.
At the house, among the snapshots of happier times, Yukari finds what she came for. Her mother's kimonos are piled up. But today is not just about taking what they need. At the graveyard, they remember how much they've had to leave behind.
Of course, the big question now is whether it is safe to go anywhere near Fukushima. The authorities in Japan say it is, but even as we were there within the last 24 hours, temperatures in reactor number 2 rose to 82 degrees centigrade. That prompted fears that perhaps it's not in a state of cold shutdown. A year later, Japan is still dealing with the nuclear fallout.
Thank you. Hamish Macdonald in Japan.